We have to translate the table into algebraic expressions, and we'll consider one row at a time. So we first need an algebraic expression for some number. Because the number is unknown, let's use the variable n to represent some number. Next we have the sum of the number n3. Sum means addition, so the expression would be n plus 3 for the sum of the number n3. Next we have twice the sum of the number n3. To get twice a value, we multiply by 2, and therefore twice the sum of a number n3 would be 2 times the quantity n plus 3. Next we have a length. The length is unknown. Let's use the variable l. Double the length. To get double a length or double an amount, we multiply by 2. So double the length would be 2 times l or 2l. And next we have double the length decreased by 6. To decrease the value by 6, we subtract 6. And therefore double the length decreased by 6 would be 2l minus 6. Next we have a cost. Let's use the variable c for the cost. Then we have the difference of the cost and 20. Difference means subtraction, so we have c minus 20 for the difference of c and 20, or the difference of the cost and 20. Next we have 2 times the difference of the cost and 20, which would be 2 times the quantity c minus 20. Next we have some quantity. Let's use the variable q for that quantity. The difference of 5 in the quantity, again difference means subtraction, so the difference of 5 in the quantity would be 5 minus q. So notice how the difference of the cost and 20 is c minus 20. The difference of 5 in the quantity is 5 minus q. And next we have the difference of 5 and the quantity divided by 2. So we're going to divide this quantity by 2, so we'd have 5 minus q all over 2. Remember, a fraction bar means division. Next, we have an amount of time. Let's use a variable t for that time. Triple the amount of time would be 3 times the time, or 3t. Next, we have triple the amount of time increased by 5. To increase an amount by 5, we add 5, so the expression would be 3t plus 5. For our last row, for a distance, let's use the variable d. The sum of negative 4 and the distance, sum means addition, so this would be negative 4 plus d. And then finally we have the sum of negative 4 and twice the distance. Well, twice the distance would be 2d, so we have the sum of negative 4 and 2d, which would be negative 4 plus 2d. Notice here's only twice the distance, not twice the sum of negative 4 in the distance. I hope you found this helpful.